Edward or Eddie Koiki Mabo was born in 1936 on Mer Island. His mother had died at childbirth and he was adopted by his uncle and aunt, Benny and Maga Mabo. When he was 16, he was exiled from Mer Island because of a romance. He had a fling with a girl out of wedlock. He was exiled from 12 months. Eddie travelled to Australia and he started working across Queensland by doing jobs such as a cane cutter. While he was travelling, he met Bonita Nihau, and at the age of 23, they got married, and this was in 1959. They ended up having 9 children. Well, it's 9 or 10, but sources do differ. But most of them say 9, so I'm going to say 9. From 1967 to 1971, he was employed to work as a gardener at James Cook University in Townsville. Eddie used to read books from the library and attend some seminars. He was particularly interested in history and anthropology. Later on, he started teaching seminars about race and culture. He also had a seminar called We Are the Australians, what is to follow after the referendum about Aboriginal rights. Actually, in 1981 to 1984, Mabo studied for a diploma of teaching at James Cook University and the Townsville College of Advanced Learning. He was also involved with a trade union in Townsville, and he also established Australia's first black community school in 1973. It was the turning point of his life. It was in 1974 that Mabo found out something very devastating. While talking about Mer Island and how his family lived on the land for a very long time, Professor Noel Lewes and Henry Reynolds had to break the news to him that the Crown owned the land. Koiki was surprised, shocked and even. I remember him saying, "No way, it's not theirs, it's ours." After that, in 1981, a land rights conference was held in Townsville. The point was brought up about land ownership on Mer Island, and a lawyer said that they could claim rights through the court system. In May 1982, Mabo, along with 5 other Maryam men, started the case about native title and the Terra Nullius Law. The men's names were Sam Passy, Father Dave Passy, James Rice, Salua Mapo Sali, and of course Eddie Koiki Mabo. The Terra Nullius Law was that when the British settlers came, they basically said that no one owned the land, even though there were people living on it for thousands of years. Terra Nullius means land belonging to no one. So when the court case started, when it was with the Queensland Court, the Queensland State Parliament passed a law, the Queensland Coast Declaratory Act of 1985, which said that any rights that Torres Strait Islanders had to land after the claim of sovereignty in 1879 is hereby extinguished without compensation. This act was then challenged because it was in conflict with the Commonwealth Racial Discrimination Act. This happened in 1988, and it was known as Mabo 1. But then, in 1989, his claims about the land on Mer Island were dismissed. The Justice Supreme Court of Queensland found out that Eddie wasn't Benny Mabo's son, so Eddie's claims were denied. Although he was upset, he kept on pursuing the case. Then in January 1992, Eddie Koiki Mabo died of cancer. He sadly never got to see the end of the case. But in June 1992, the Terra Nullius Law was extinguished. 6 judges had agreed that Mabo and his team did have traditional ownership of the land. It was said that The Mariam people are entitled, as against the whole world, to possession, occupation, use, and enjoyment of the lands of the Murray Islands. This was the first time that native title was recognised in Australia. And it was also said that Terra Nullius violated human rights. So in 1993, the Commonwealth Parliament passed the Native Title Act that let the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people throughout Australia claim traditional rights to the land. So what's the significance of this? This was a major stepping stone for having equal rights for all Australians. They finally got back, which was taken away from them many, many years ago. Eddie Mabo is now buried in Mur Island after his grave was vandalised in Townsville.